Welcome to this presentation on ProQuest History Vault. In this presentation, we are going to look at records on social movements in ProQuest History Vault, and I will be giving some possible ideas for research projects that a student might work on using the collections in History Vault. I want to start by giving some background information on History Vault. History Vault consists of archival and manuscript collections digitized by ProQuest from a wide range of archival institutions. Many of these collections were originally available in microfilm, and we have now digitized them in History Vault. History Vault also contains a number of collections that have been scanned from originals and are published only in History Vault. Here on the screen now, we are looking at a portion of the History Vault homepage. The collections in History Vault are divided into 8 major topic areas, and those topics are shown here. One of the major strengths of History Vault is its collections on American social movements, especially the Civil Rights Movement and the Women's Rights Movement. On the Civil Rights Movement, History Vault includes records of 4 of the most important civil rights organizations of the 1950s and 1960s in the form of the NAACP papers, Southern Christian Leadership Conference records, Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee papers, and Congress of Racial Equality records. On women's rights, major collections include National Woman's Party papers, records from the Schlesinger Library at Radcliffe College, and the Margaret Sanger papers. In recent years, we have added strong collections focused on the American labor movement, anti-Vietnam War movement, and radical political organizations. In this presentation, I'm going to focus on these 3 topics, while I will also point out some of the relationships between these movements and the civil rights movement. As many of you know, social movements are a popular topic for students and researchers at all levels. And the Black Freedom and NAACP collections in History Vault have been among our most popular. I have prepared a presentation that gives ideas for research topics using the Black Freedom collections and NAACP collections in History Vault. And that presentation is available at slideshare.net on the ProQuest channel there. And you can find it by looking for Black Freedom and NAACP. As shown on the bottom of the screen is the address. And so within that presentation, I've identified 75 topics, and I'm showing the first 15 topics on the screen now within that presentation. And these are literally just a small handful of the many topics that a student might pursue using the NAACP and Black Freedom collections in History Vault. Here in this graphic on the screen now, from humanitiesdata.org, we see the topics that would have been covered at the OAH annual meeting that was supposed to have taken place in April 2020. You can see that many of the topics pertain to social movements, starting at the top with activism and working down to gender, labor, politics and power, and work and law. In addition, we know that graduate students have found History Vault to be useful in their work. And here on the screen now are theses and dissertations that cite History Vault in their footnotes. And here I am showing the covers of books in which the authors have used and cited History Vault among their sources. And here are more books again that used and cited History Vault among their sources. On both these slides, these last 2 screens, a number of the books pertain to social movement topics, especially the civil rights movement. Another book that used History Vault as one of its sources is Pull Power by Evan Falconberry. After Pull Power was published, I corresponded with Professor Falconberry, and he told me that he first used History Vault as a graduate student at the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill. He explained how searching across History Vault content led him to results and documents that he did not expect to find in collections that he had not planned to look at. And he said that these results helped him to tell a more complete story of the Voter Education Project. In this presentation, I will refer to that idea by looking at other 20th century social movements in the United States and showing some of their connections to the civil rights movement. The first set of records I want to highlight are very much connected to the civil rights movement, and these are the records of the African American Police League. The African American Police League collection consists of annual reports, court files, minutes, correspondence, police brutality report files, and publications and flyers covering the work of the AAPL and its education arm, the League to Improve the Community. The collection also includes materials on the National Black Police Association. The National Black Police Association series includes coverage of police community relations in 30 cities, including Atlanta, Houston, Memphis, Milwaukee, New Orleans, New York, Newark, New Jersey, Philadelphia, Oakland, and St. Louis. Shifting gears now to radical politics, I want to highlight the records of the Socialist Party of America. Jack Ross, in his recent book, The Socialist Party of America, A Complete History, has noted that the Socialist Party was the most important minor political party in the history of the United States in the 20th century, and that the Socialist Party had a wide-ranging impact and a respected place in the national conversation for a half century. Among the topics a student might research using the Socialist Party of America papers are the Socialist Party's relationship to the civil rights movement, the evolution of the Socialist Party during the 20th century, internal disputes within the Socialist Party, the role of women in the Socialist Party, the Socialist Party in presidential elections, the leadership of Norman Thomas and others, and the Socialist Party's response to the Great Depression and the New Deal. And here on the screen now are examples of documents in the Socialist Party collection as digitized in History Vault. On the topic of the Socialist Party and the Civil Rights Movement, several important civil rights leaders had connection with or were members of the Socialist Party, including A. Philip Randolph, James Farmer, James Peck, Bayard Rustin, Pauli Murray, and others. Here we see an advanced search in History Vault on civil rights limited to the Socialist Party module, and we see that we get over 1,000 results. I can also search on some of the specific people or events important to civil rights. Here I ran a search on the longtime civil rights leader A. Philip Randolph, who organized the 1941 March on Washington movement and the 1963 March on Washington. I'm showing here one result from the search that I restricted to the Socialist Party of America module, and you can see that in total in that search, I had 713 results. If I then expand the search, that same search on Randolph, but I expand it to all modules, you can see now on the screen the results across all History Vault modules. And on the left side of the screen, you can see the different collections represented, including the NAACP collections and other collections on the Black freedom struggle. And here is an advanced search in the Socialist Party module on Bayard Rustin. As you might know, Rustin was a key colleague of Randolph, and Rustin was the key behind-the-scenes organizer of the 1963 March on Washington. And here, I'm now showing the search on Rustin expanded to all History Vault modules. And like the Randolph search, you can see results across many modules. So these two slides go back to Evan Falconberry's point about finding documents in collections that you did not plan to look at. So both Bayard Rustin and A. Philip Randolph were not only heavily involved in the civil rights movement, they were also heavily involved in the American labor movement. And during the 1930s to the 1960s and into the 1970s, several major labor organizations, such as the United Automobile Workers and the Congress of Industrial Organizations, provided support to the civil rights movement. Records showing the relationship between the labor movement and the civil rights movement can be found in two other History Vault modules that are focused on the labor movement. The first module I'm showing on the screen now is Labor Unions in the U.S. 1862 to 1974. And here, I'm showing the module page from History Vault. And every module in History Vault has a page like this, with an image from the module on the left. You can do an advanced search on the module or browse collections from the green buttons on the bottom left. There's a description of the module in the middle, and then the suggested searches on the right side. This module includes records of the Congress of Industrial Organizations from 1935 to 1955 and records of the AFL from 1955 to 1974. These and other collections in this module include documentation on the civil rights movement, on labor's role in the New Deal, the evolution of labor organizations over time, labor's connection to issues like Social Security, maximum hours, and minimum wages. And this module also includes two collections on the Knights of Labor at the turn of the 20th century. Under the leadership of Terence Powderly, the Knights of Labor made a conscious effort to organize Black and women workers. History Vault's coverage of the labor movement continues in the module called Workers, Labor Unions, and the American Left in the 20th Century. This module includes Department of Justice investigations of the Communist Party and the industrial workers of the world, and investigations on the federal government's use of force in labor unrest. And it also includes a fascinating series of U.S. military reports on radicals from 1917 to 1941. Closely related to these records on radicals is another module called FBI Confidential Files and Radical Politics in the U.S. 1945 to 1972. Here you can see some of the collections in this module and also two documents in the module. As it is noted on the screen, the surreptitious entries file contains strong documentation on the Socialist Workers' Party and the Weather Underground. And here is a screenshot of the portion of the timeline in History Vault. The timeline is organized by topic, as seen on the left side of the screen. Students can pick a topic and find events related to that topic. The timeline in History Vault is also a great tool for teachers because they can assign a topic and students can then explore events in that topic. So a student can use the timeline to get started in their research, even if they did not have a solid topic in mind before they came to History Vault. Here in this screenshot, I have the timeline filtered on the topic of communism and anti-communism, as you can see with the white highlighting on the left side. And this topic is relevant to the FBI Confidential Files module. And you can see that the entry for 1940 is Hoover issuing the instructions for the Do Not File file. And the Do Not File file is one of the collections in the FBI Confidential Files module. The records on the Weather Underground that I mentioned with the FBI module are closely related to the next two modules that I want to talk about. The first of these two modules is American Politics and Society from Kennedy to Watergate. This module includes records on the Johnson administration's response to the anti-Vietnam War movement, records of the President's Commission on Campus Unrest, FBI files on the American Indian Movement, and records of the National Council on Indian Opportunity. Another collection in this module is the records of the National Commission on Violence. The records of the National Commission on Violence includes a major series of records on the protests at the 1968 Democratic National Convention in Chicago and the Republican National Convention in Miami. Two of the groups involved in the Chicago protests were Students for a Democratic Society and Vietnam Veterans Against the War. And here on the screen now, I'm showing a search that I ran from the timeline in History Vault. You can see on the Democratic National Convention. And you can see on the left side of the screen that the two organizations that I mentioned, Students for a Democratic Society and Vietnam Veterans Against the War, are represented in this search. And that brings me to the next module that I want to talk about, and that is entitled Students for a Democratic Society, Vietnam Veterans Against the War, and the Anti-Vietnam War Movement. So SDS, as you might know, is one of the most well-known organizations of the 1960s, and it was heavily influenced by the civil rights movement. In its early years, SDS emphasized participatory democracy, community building, and creating a political movement of impoverished people. all of these were important to the civil rights movement, and many SDS members had started their activism in the civil rights movement. As U.S. involvement in the Vietnam War escalated in the mid-1960s, SDS became involved in the anti-Vietnam War movement, as did other civil rights leaders, including Martin Luther King Jr. And here on the screen now, we see two examples of documents related to SDS's shift to anti-Vietnam War activism. The other major collection in this module on the anti-Vietnam War movement is the records of the Vietnam Veterans Against the War. In his book, The Turning, A History of Vietnam Veterans Against the War, Andrew Hunt makes the following point. He writes, Vietnam Veterans Against the War is an organization that has rarely received adequate consideration in the standard 60s histories. The organization could boast everything that SDS claimed. Tens of thousands of members, at least on mailing lists. Chapters in all parts of the country. Sponsorship of social programs such as drug counseling for poor veterans. And by 1972, policy papers containing critiques of capitalism that surpassed SDS's founding manifesto, the Port Huron Statement. And on the left side of this slide, you see the section of the History Vault timeline with the anti-Vietnam War movement topic selected. And you can see the first event listed is for 1967 as the founding of the VVAW. And on the screen now, you are looking at documents from the Vietnam Veterans Against the War collection. And this collection and the others in this module are sourced by ProQuest from the Wisconsin Historical Society. So Professor Hunt used the VVAW collection to write The Turning before ProQuest digitized the collection. But after we digitized the collection, I contacted Professor Hunt and he reviewed the Vietnam Veterans Against the War collection in History Vault. And he had this to say. History Vault impressed me deeply. I use a lot of historical databases, but this one stands out as one of the best and most user-friendly I've encountered. Revisiting digitized veteran VVAW documents, I saw much that was familiar, but I also encountered a lot of new sources that hadn't yet been made accessible when I was doing my research. In fact, touring ProQuest History Vault, I was struck by how much of VVAW's history was new to me. There are still so many VVAW stories waiting to be told. On the idea of stories waiting to be told, I want to shift gears now and look at the first half of the 20th century, as well as the late 19th century. Up until now, most of this presentation has focused on the 20th century since World War II. So the first collection on the early 20th century is records of Pinkerton's National Detective Agency. Earlier, I talked about labor unions and the labor movement. In the Pinkerton files, we have the opposite side, as there are several files on union busting. There are also other research possibilities in the Pinkerton records, as seen in the top right of the screen. And on the lower right side of the screen is a book cover of the book Inventing the Pinkertons. And in this book, the author used the original paper records of Pinkerton's National Detective Agency among his sources. This collection is held at the Library of Congress, and this is the collection that we have digitized in History Vault. We've recently released on History Vault three new modules on the Progressive Era. These Progressive Era modules go well with the other modules I've covered in the presentation because the Progressive Era, dating from roughly 1890 to 1928, is one of the great reform movements in American history. There were four constitutional amendments passed during the Progressive Era, and one of those was the 19th Amendment, in which women won the right to vote. And on that topic, History Vault has some outstanding collections pertaining to the women's suffrage movement, highlighted by the National Woman's Party papers, and a large series of collections from the Schlesinger Library at Radcliffe College. I spoke with the author of the book, A Woman's Crusade, Alice Paul and the Battle for the Ballot. And as you might know, Paul was the energetic leader of the National Woman's Party. And you can see towards the top of the screen Mary Walton's positive assessment of the importance of the National Women's Party papers, in which where it starts out, no serious account of the political, cultural, and political revolution that underlay the 19th Amendment is complete without a reading of the National Women's Party papers. Another key women's rights collection in History Vault is the Margaret Sanger papers, an important source for the evolution of the reproductive rights movement in the 20th century. In the Schlesinger collections that I mentioned just a second ago, in addition to the material on the suffrage movement, the Schlesinger collection also includes the papers of Mary Ware Dennett and the Voluntary Parenthood League. So Dennett was a key rival of Sanger, but prior to her work on reproductive rights, Dennett was also involved in the women's suffrage movement, and there is correspondence of Dennett in the National Women's Party papers. And that brings me to the conclusion of the presentation. And as a way to conclude, I want to highlight a few of the themes that I alluded to during the presentation. We have seen that History Vault's coverage of social movements is very strong, and that searching across collections can lead to new discoveries and allow researchers to find new documents that they might not have looked at. And this can help make research projects more complete. Here on the slide now, we see three testimonials about History Vault, indicating how some of the search capabilities and other access points have helped students and professors in their research. So in review, here, these are the modules on social movements in History Vault that I've covered during this presentation. And as I described, these collections offer students many new research possibilities and opportunities to tell new stories. As Andrew Hunt said, these collections await the curious eyes of historians. There are still so many stories waiting to be told. And with that, I will conclude today's presentation. For more tips on searching History Vault, please be sure to look at the ProQuest LibGuides. And you can see the address for the LibGuides at the top right of the screen, proquest.libguides.com. The LibGuides offer helpful suggestions for searching ProQuest products. And if you would like to trial any ProQuest products, you can sign up for trials at the URL listed on the screen, trials.proquest.com. Thank you for listening to today's presentation, and I hope that these ProQuest products will prove helpful to you in the future, and I wish you the best of success in your research and your teaching. Thank you.